Web APIs can return responses to the calling client in a variety of different ways. And those responses might represent successful operations, failed operations, or even operations we might want to retry. Also, we might want to associate some data with those responses. And so that could represent a collection of things, one thing, or maybe we just want to send over an empty body. In this video, we're going to look at some of the options for returning data from our web APIs inside of ASP.NET Core. You might recall from earlier in the series that our get operation looks something like this, where we were only returning a list of strings. And while this works fine, this operation doesn't give us the flexibility that we need to apply some of those web API conventions. Now, we still want to be able to return data from our API, but we also want to be able to control the responses that get sent back to the client. And we're going to see how we can do this using a facility known as action results. Now, the first thing that we need to do to apply action results is, well, I'm going to change the name of my return type, and I'm going to return a type of action result. Now, the next thing I want to do is, well, I want to return an HTTP OK. That means it was a successful response, and I also want to provide the data. So what I can actually do is I can call the OK method, and then I can pass to that method the data that I want to have returned to the client. Now, you might be wondering, well, where exactly did this OK method come from? And it turns out there's a lot of helper methods that are available inside of that controller base class that will allow us to return action results. Let's try and return another one. Let's say, for instance, our recipes type didn't have anything in it. So let's say recipes.any was empty. Now, one of the things we might want to do is return a not found. And returning not found signals to our client that, well, we weren't able to find anything that you were looking for. And notice how we can do that by just calling the not found method. So not only can we return our data using a successful OK response, but we can also signal other types of responses as well. If you continue digging around inside of that controller base class, you'll notice that there's tons of other helper methods that are there to allow us to return common action results. Action results are really good for returning customized responses to our API clients, but they're also really helpful when it comes to generating the metadata that gets used in our Swagger UI. Now, stay tuned because in the next video, we're going to learn how to pull information out of the HTTP request using a concept known as binding.